Fittest family is back. Right now, 12 super fit families are descending on the site of our first challenge, the world famous obstacle course Tough Mudder in County Meath. 12 brand new extraordinary families join us this year.
We're going to take Ireland's fittest family title back down to the rebel county, where it belongs.
Some are super confident.
The competition looks pretty tough, they look big, but that night I don't think we can handle.
For some, the nerves are already showing.
A bit daunting now that we've arrived.
But all are fast, powerful, tactical, and have their eyes on the prize.
It's going to be tough, but it's going to be tough for all families. We're ready to give it a good lash.
We may be the smallest and we may be the youngest, but don't write us off.
Four Irish sporting legends will be coaching our teams, hopefully to fittest family victory.
We're there with them!
Come on!
The coaches are tough. Their reputations are on the line and they're desperate to win.
Get up!
Come on!
Fast steps!
What are you waiting for?
Pull him up, come on!
Yes!
Over 8 weeks, these competitive families will push themselves physically and mentally, hurtling themselves at some of the most challenging obstacle courses and terrains Ireland has to offer, until there's just one family left standing to take the title. Battle is on to find Ireland's fittest family 2016. Yes! Next up, it's the cricket-loving Maritzes from Dublin.
Lara is very crazy. She's outgoing.
She's competitive and really strong.
Both of my sisters are serious competitors when it comes to the cricket because they're twins. When they come together, they're unstoppable.
They are so strong. They really like to train.
Come on, guys!
Chris Ivan is very confident, very mature.
I'm going to bring the strength, mostly, considering I'm the only male in the family.
When I entered, I was really nervous, but I thought, oh, we won't get in. And then we got in, and I went, oh my goodness, what am I gonna do?
I'm trying, guys.
I confess that I'm not the fittest mom, but I know I have a very fit family. They are the ones that pushes me and drives me on.
I'm just gonna focus and do it.
It's the turn of the Maritzes from North Dublin. 3 minutes, 30 seconds was the time from the Hollands, but the Maritzes don't know that yet. They'll find out afterwards. All they can do is impress the coaches. Joe O'Connor gets them underway. And Chris Devan, who's the fittest member of this family, is first to the Devil's Dip. He's the only male member of this team. And that's an interesting tactic.
He just threw her over. Did you see that?
He's an animal.
He's unreal, boy.
Chris Devan is writing his own rules for this Loch Ness monster time trial.
Go! Mum waited for him. Fair play, Chantel.
Mum Chantel doesn't like the cold water. I wouldn't blame her. Well, they've become separated, and Chris Devan has been doing a lot of work helping the other members of his team, but he's got to get over the second block, and he's done that now.
This is a team family, this is. Come on, Chantel.
They're back together. Chantel was concerned about her fitness levels. Her kids have been training her, getting her ready for Ireland's fittest family.
Get him up!
Has it paid off? So, Chris Devan up to the top of the wall, and let's see what he does here.
Take your time, regroup. Well done. Come on, get her up. Get your leg. Well done, get it over.
Twins Lara and Tess are hugely into cricket.
Come on, you gotta push her up. Come on. Get her up.
This is costing them some time. Chantel is up there now.
Come on.
And back down.
Well done. Off you go.
So that's the first wall done for the Maritzes. And there is the time, and they're doing extremely well. They are ahead of where the Hollands were at this stage. Will they be able to keep it going?
I have to get this now. One go. Get her up.
And their tactics, which worked on the first wall, repeated now on the second.
Well done.
Off you go!
There's a little bit of a slip there. 3:30, the time to beat, set by the Hollands. Here come the Maritzes from Dublin. And that is brilliant. That's a superb time. 3 minutes and 2 seconds.
Spectacular. No, I didn't really expect my family to do that well.
My mum, I was very proud of her. She was really good at it. She didn't give up and she just fought through the pain.
I couldn't get over the wall, but Chris even kind of like just, he just like got me over. I don't know how.
I think we were the underdogs, you know, because it was 3 goals and 1 mile.
Yeah, the Maritzes were a surprise package for me.
I have to say, fair play to them. They were excellent today.
They worked well as a unit, unbelievable, and they're fair driving them.
Come on, let's go.
Welcome back to Ireland's Fittest Family. So as it stands, the Maritzes top the leaderboard and the Hollands are in the eliminator. Will the Maritzes be able to keep the top spot? We've barely started Ireland's Fittest Family 2016 and in just a few moments we'll say goodbye to one family for good. It's the Hollands versus the Maritzes in tonight's first eliminator.
The eliminator is tough and tests all aspects of fitness. The race starts with a 500 metres dash. Then the families face the Liberator Wall, the energy-sapping Mud Mile, and the claustrophobic rat tunnels. The race ends with a sprint to Everest, a 12-foot halfpipe. Once all four members of the family ascend to the summit, we'll have our winner, and for the losing family, it's all over.
I'm blank. I can't think. I'm just depending on Chris, Ivan and the 2 girls. That's all I do.
Miss, don't stress. It's going to be okay.
We have a few things under our sleeve anyway, so we'll try our best. Hopefully you guys are away.
The Hollands, we've talked and we've mingled a lot with them, so they're like our friends, but now we have to be like enemies with them now.
The big focus is keeping our heads in the game, trying to get us through, and then we can just push through to the end and hopefully be through to the next round.
It's all or nothing in tonight's first eliminator. Who has a future in this competition? Will it be the Maritzes or the Hollands?
3, 2, 1.
First, they have to run 500 metres. And a sprightly start from the Maritzes. Christovan leading the way. But the Maritzes have split up 2 and 2. The Hollands staying together. There's Christovan Maritz. This is the Liberator Wall. The competitors can use those pegs to get up over the wall.
Watch this now, look.
Yeah.
Brilliant.
Chantel getting help. There's Steve Holland. Maritzes are fractionally ahead. You really can't tell from that picture, but now they are in front.
Nice one, guys, come on!
Now they have a lead on the Hollands. That was nicely done.
Don't panic.
No, there's a way to go. Okay, come on.
Go on, don't panic, well done.
Well, there's a long way to go. You just can't panic out on this eliminator course.
Keep right!
It's the Maritzes who head towards the Mud Mile first. This is where it all gets very messy. The Maritzes have a lead on the Hollands and they're all in the same mud and water pools. And the Hollands have made up some ground on the Maritzes. They're in the orange tops. That lead is closed right up. They have got right up close and personal again with the Maritzes. This is set up for a very dramatic finish. Christovan for once isn't the first out of an obstacle. He's had some help. And look at that, Amy Holland has gone out in front for her family. So they have closed right up. And the pressure and the panic will be with the Maritzes right now. But they are together. The Maritzes nearest the camera, but the Hollands getting stronger. Christovan is the first out, and the Hollands, look at that. They will go in front now. Just about, but all four members of the Holland family using their rock climbing experience, bringing that to bear on this eliminator. They're out in front, and the Maritzes are in trouble. But just how much trouble? There's still a long way to go.
Come on, power your legs, come on.
This is the wall of pain, and this could bring them right up together again.
Great attitude.
Stay with it.
Hollands have one member of their family over. It's 15 foot high. So two members of the Holland family over. There's 15-year-old Tess Maritz, who is the first of her family members to get over the wall, but she looks shattered. Christavan next over. They've two. The Hollands have three. Frankie has got over the wall. The rat tunnels are next, and the Hollands still lead, but only just. And Amy Holland is the first up to the rat tunnels, closely followed by her dad, Steve. And the Maritz is still having trouble on that wall of pain. The appropriately named. And Amy has got through the rat tunnels and takes on the half pipe, but she looks absolutely shattered at this stage. And she's going to need some help. And her mum, Frankie, will be there shortly. There's Christavan Maritz. They're trying to make up ground. They are desperately trying to close the gap on the Hollands.
Suck it in, suck it in.
So first attempt on the half pipe for Bernard Holland. And he's made it. That's really good from Bernard Holland. And they have somebody up there to help the other family members. But the Maritzes are closing.
Power, power, power.
And that was very close from Tess Maritz. Very close just isn't good enough. Christavan has got up there. So that's a help. We're set up for a pretty dramatic finish because this can change very quickly. And Christavan drags Lara, his sister, up. So they've got two up. Steve Holland failed on the far side. Here comes Tess Maritz. The Hollands only with one up. And now, oh no, Steve's missed again. The Maritzes are ahead for sure. That's Amy Holland, so it's level. They've two each up there. Frankie offering instructions. She has got up there now, so they've just got one to get up to the top of the half pipe. The pressure is building. The panic builds as well. And the Maritzes have got three, have they? Have they? So now it's three each between the Maritzes and the Hollands. It's down to the parents, Steve Holland and Chantelle Maritz. The tension of this is absolutely incredible. It's as tight as it gets. They're both being clung onto. Who is it going to be? It is the Maritzes. They've got Chantelle up there. They go through. It's elimination for the Hollands. But what an incredible race. And it was a matter of inches right at the end.
That was actually incredible, wasn't it?
Unbelievable.
The Hollands are out of Ireland's Fittest Family.
That was so close, and we so wanted to win.
I don't know how many you've had like that, but that's not good for the heart.
That was incredible, wasn't it? There was some effort went in up there, in fairness.
I think the disappointment's going to set in once the adrenaline's worn off, but we had a great time, and we gave it our best shot.
I'm extremely proud of my family, like my sister, my mum, my dad. They all pulled through so much.
That was seriously crazy, like, wow.
No words can experience what I've just felt there. When I went up there and we touched, I actually just hit the floor and I wanted to cry on the spot. Like, I was so proud of my family. I didn't think my mom would do it.
Woo! Mom, you look at you.
I'm very emotional, totally emotional. I can't believe it. I actually started crying. I just can't. I after a few minutes, I asked them, did we win? And they went, yay. I just closed my eyes and I collapsed. It was the hardest thing ever.
I was like, Mom, come on, please do it for us. And then she did it for us, and I'm so happy.
Oh no, we won! We're gonna do it all again!
Up for selection are the McCarthys, the Mullins, the Baileys, and the Maritzes.
The Mullins and the Baileys, I think there isn't much there between them. I think there's more in the Mullinses to get out of them. They're hardy, they're tough, and I don't think anything will faze them.
I'd be very happy with the Baileys, more so than Davey thinks to a certain degree.
The Maritzes, they actually performed really well. They shocked me. With them three, I'm very undecided. Just because they're from Clare. Only that reason. I'd like to work with the McCarthys. They're average enough. Not. They're pretty good.
He's 100% desperate to get the McCarthys, you can tell. They're really strong, really positive. If I get first choice, I'm definitely going to go for the McCarthys.
Would it make me sick if Stephen got the McCarthys? Yeah.
Now, I'm going to toss a coin here.
I'm going to give you heads, Susie, you're the newbie. Davey, your tails, OK?
Yeah.
Winner of the toss gets to choose their family first. It's heads.
So, Stephen, your first family is?
McCarthy's. Welcome.
OK. Davey, over to you.
I'm going to go with the Mullinses.
Back to you, Stephen.
Bailey's. Welcome.
So, Davey.
And Maritz.
You have the Maritz.
Yeah.
OK, guys, go meet your families.
So,
best of luck.
Guys, how are we doing? I will be a strategist. I love thinking stuff out, so we're going to be smarter.
Well, you may get focused now because you've got another clear man after you, so. And you know what? He's like a dog now.
We've given up on nothing. And I believe we can get them. We're going to get a go, I know, you know? You didn't think I'd pick them, did you? Listen, I could have got it completely wrong.
Yeah.
We're about to see.
Look.
Hey, best of luck, all right?
Nice.
Next up, it's the cricket mad Maritzes from North County Dublin. Their coach, GAA Bonnestore Davey Fitz, was keen to put his opinions on the table.
Let's be pretty blunt, OK? I want to give it to you straight. What it's going to come down to probably is you, right? I'm not putting massive pressure on you, but this is what the three you got to think of. You've got to be around her as much as possible.
My mum is the weak one in the family, so I'm going to stick for my mum, the wife route.
Ready, steady, go! The twins and Christophan need to really push Chantel. They have to come out of themselves and actually push her that extra bit again, get her through that PM barrier, and if we can do that, we could surprise a few people.
Christophan!
That is way better than what I thought. And I don't think you give yourself enough of credit. Everyone thinks you're a soft touch because
yeah,
we have
three girls
here. We're in trouble. We're not in trouble. But the most important thing, not looking down into the water. Get your mind to a place that's just comfortable. Let's just go for it, all right?
Nothing to lose.
Nothing to lose.
And the Maritzes are about to start hanging tough.
Basically, it's meditation. You just need to breathe. I'm going to hang in there. I told the girls they're going to need to hang for dear life.
I feel a bit nervous, but I think I can do this.
They think we're the weakest team. We'll show them what the story is. Are we ready to go?
Yeah.
Give it everything, all right? Let's go.
OK, families, take your grip. Crane on standby. And up.
That's it, off the ground. Now just get there. That's it, get in your focus.
Well, that's exactly what they have. It's written all over their faces, this young family from North Dublin. You would think that Christophan there would be the favourite to stay up there
that's
the longest.
It.
Chantel.
Get that face.
Their
girl.
Mother
well
is
done.
Wriggling on that bar already, and as she spoke about this quiet place.
Well done. Not a bother. Get to the place, nice and relaxed, like we talked about.
She's regained her composure and it looks not a bother at the minute. The Maritzes are all very composed at this stage. Chantel moving again on the bar.
Like the other day, hang in there, that's the girl. Well,
but they're up to the minute mark and this is an impressive start from the Maritzes. Remember, all four times are combined. Chantel, well, had a glimpse of panic on her face and Tess starts to move as well.
That's fantastic.
This is where it's really going to start to burn. And Chantel now with her eyes open.
Hang tough. Well done, Chantel. Hang tough. Well done. You're a fighter.
Maybe that quiet place isn't so quiet anymore. But they're all still up there.
That's brilliant.
Chantel.
Well done.
And at the moment, Chantel is very uncomfortable.
Relax.
Having a look down at the water, and she is gone in. But a very impressive performance. 141.
Now we have to work. Stay looking up, Tess.
Christophan, Lara and Tess still there. And this is a superb performance from the Maritzes.
Lara, stay there.
Tess now moving and Christophan as well. And Christophan surprisingly has gone in just shy of 2 minutes. So it's all down to the twins.
Now you have to stay, Lara.
Tess gone in. And Lara, 15-year-old Lara, is fighting with all she's worth to stay up there.
Stay there.
Brilliant performance and a great time.
Help her, guys.
And there is encouragement from the rest of Lara's family. But she's gone into the water 2:23, but that is absolutely brilliant. And just look at the combined time, 8 minutes and 6 seconds. They have blown the Ryans out of the water.
Oh, that was amazing. They were great.
I'm so surprised my sister's been the longest there. So I was actually delighted she did the best. Like, she pulled us through them. if we get through, that few seconds was all on her, and I'm so proud of her.
Proud of them?
That's phenomenal. I love the fighting spirit these have. We'll cause a shock before today is over.
Let's go. Well done.
So with two hanging tough events down, already the Maritzes are in the lead, which should make Davy Fitz one very happy coach. After the break, can the McCarthys from Clare or the Cummins from Tipperary do what it takes to beat them? We'll see you then.
Don't go anywhere.
Keep your focus.
So our families have showered off, they've warmed up and they're wearing clean clothes. They are chomping at the bit, trying to find out who has the best combined score. And I'm going to tell them.
I know you're all very, very eager to find out what your combined score was for each family. And I'm obviously here to put you out of your misery. In fourth place, after hanging tough, with a combined time of 5 minutes and 23 seconds, it's the Ryan family. In third place, with a combined time of 6 minutes and 38 seconds, it's the McCarthys. In second place, with a very good combined time of 8 minutes and 6 seconds, it's the Maritzes. Which means, obviously, in first place, after our first event today, with the combined time of 9 minutes and 20 seconds, phenomenal time, it's the Cummins family. Well done.
I was really surprised we actually won it.
Boost our confidence a little bit, I suppose. It's not over yet, though.
I've never met a group of people that underestimate themselves so much. This is a family that's not going to get cocky. They're one of those families that deserves it.
I'm surprised that we came here and we're the underdogs and we just showed them that we can kick ass.
I'd say the other coaches got a bit of a shock. Don't think they saw it coming.
It's not nice being last. Hopefully we have the ability to move on.
The Ryans were definitely disappointed, but we have a chance now to put it right, and I think that's the key.
We were kind of disappointed that we didn't get first because we strive to win every competition.
I thought they went down too easy, but my job is to try and pick them up.
Did you just make the wrong pick, or what was the story?
No, I picked the right family.
You definitely picked... I wonder, are they happy with the manager they got, or not?
They're happy, don't you worry about that.
Well, listen, it wasn't a bad result for you.
No,
you came toward, no? Fair play to you, all right?
Yeah, yeah.
We'll talk to you later, okay?
See you later.
He's not a happy bunny, so he's not... Like, he has the favourites tag for today. Still think he's got a great team, but they're under pressure.
I picked the McCarthys on the basis that they're a good all-round team. I still have plenty of belief in the McCarthys. I'm sure they'll go again, they're tough.
We're just about to start our second race, the Crane Drain. Now remember, the results from this race will be added to the scoreboard and will tell us who's in tonight's head-to-head eliminator.
The Crane Drain is a head-to-head event featuring all four families. Two members from each family will be required to complete the Crane Drain tonight. One member from each family will be based on the ground, and the second will be lifted by crane 80 foot onto the top of a container tower. The family member on the ground must carry 15 water drums, each weighing 15 kilos, across a 20-foot balance beam. They must connect each of these to a pulley. Once connected, the family members up above must hoist the drums one by one as quickly as possible into the container tower. The first family with all 15 drums into the container is the winner. If there's a tie after our two events today, the Crane Drain acts as the decider. So, the pressure is really on to perform.
Let's go, let's go, let's go!
The coaches have a tough decision to make.
Here's the man. You're the man I want up top. The balance beam. Lara has done a bit of gymnastics, like you should be able for this. I think we have a chance. We're in second place, guys.
Yeah.
We need a first or a second here. And we can do this.
Alan Quinlan needs to get those points on the board, so has selected Dad Danny and 22-year-old Keane.
Basically, guys, we're under pressure, so we've got to go as hard as we can. We just get it into our mindset now that we're going to beat everyone else.
Stephen Hunt has selected Jason on the ground and David to do the heavy lifting.
We'll be focused on what we want to do. Don't panic, keep our tempo, keep our mentality the same as what it was, and then we'll go on a minute. I'm sure of it. I've no doubt we'll get through today. By hook or by crook, we'll do it as a family.
Anna Geary has selected Jim in the container and Mark to take on the balance beams.
A lot of this will be about your forearm strength and getting into a rhythm. I really need belief now coming from you, Jim. So you need to believe the family is good enough for the top two.
Over to course master Joe O'Connor to get the families into position.
Ready to lift container one.
Roger that, Joe. Now we're
going
to proceed to the top of the tower.
After that. We can't afford coming fourth or third. Eliminate is not even an option.
I am the only girl, but I think I'm strong enough to complete this.
She's a fighter, though. She's an absolute fighter.
We're just going to give it everything, because we don't want to be in the eliminator.
We won't have the energy after this anyway to go to the eliminator, so we have to get out of this.
We won this morning against the odds. There's no reason why we can't win it this afternoon as well.
These are the sort of things that we're trained for, so I'm looking forward to the crane drain very much so.
I suppose we're confident the dad's strong enough, no doubt he'll be able to pull them up fast.
Just got to make sure that we do really well at this one and give it our all.
We're out to win. We want a full 4 points.
Tactically, just go as fast as we can. Try and get them up as quick as we can.
I'm 100% sure we'll get through today. Sometimes you got to back your team, and I'm going to back my team today.
So here are the lanes in the crane drain tonight. Tackling the balance beams for the Ryans in red is Keane. Dad Danny will be up in the container hoisting the drums. On the ground for the Cummins in pink is Mark, and Dad Jim will be in the container. For the McCarthys in yellow, Jason will be taking on the balance beams while brother David will be testing his mettle 80 feet up. Finally, for the Maritzes in lilac, 15-year-old Lara is the only girl in this event. She's on balance beams, her brother Christopher is on rope duty. With four families going head-to-head in the crane drain, there is no room for slip-ups, as every second and drum will count.
For the team members 80 feet in the air, crane drain will test upper body strength, arm strength and endurance. And for the competitors on the ground, it's all about speed and balance. Joe O'Connor starts the event.
3, 2, 1.
Off we go in the crane drain. Jason McCarthy nearest to us, taking two drums initially. Onto the balance beam. Oh, and that's a bit of a slippery start for Jason. Look at Lara Maritz. She's only 15 years of age and she flew across that balance beam. And she's got the first of those drums across and she has to attach it to the pulley. Christopher up the top. So there's the first one up for the Maritzes. Into an early lead. And Mark Cummins and Jim have combined to get one up for their family as well. So Jason McCarthy is really struggling and he's persisting with this two-drum approach. Oh, and he's just about managed to get across, so they'll have their first one up shortly. Up at the top is David McCarthy. So they have opened their account. On the other side, Mark Cummins has connected his second drum, so they will have two up there, and Keane Ryan. The Ryans have nothing up at the top of the container tower. And Keane Ryan going with two drums, and this is not going well at all. It is early days, but Keane Ryan, can he get across that? Yes, he has gone across that 20-foot balance beam. That's his dad, Danny, up at the top of the tower. So the first one up for the Ryans from Donegal. But it's the Cummins family who are now level with the Maritzes.
Well done, lad.
Stephen Hunt paying close attention to how Jason McCarthy is doing. And it ain't going well for the McCarthys, having to attach that pulley. David up at the top. So that's three for them. And Mark Cummins has now just attached the fifth drum. So they have now got five up there and a slim lead over the Maritzes. But what's happened here? Danny Ryan up at the top of the tower. Keane forgot to connect the drum. He's looking for another one. They've got three up there. This will be number four connected.
Come on, go, go.
He's the fifth one ready to go, but they need to get more across.
Come on, Danny, lean right back.
So Danny gets the fifth one up for the Ryans, and they're right there with the other families. Lara Maritz is going with two and absolutely flying over that balance beam. So it's a super performance from Lara Maritz as we head towards halfway
in the crane drain. The Cummins and the Maritzes. Now the Maritzes go in front. They've got seven up there. The McCarthys with six, and now the Cummins with seven as well. But it's a tie for the lead. And now we're with the McCarthys. There's Jason. And up at the top of the tower is David. So the McCarthys now up to seven. The Cummins family in the lead. Lara Maritz has gone off the balance beam. That's a surprise, but fatigue will start to hit now at the halfway stage or beyond it.
Focus. Good girl.
So Lara heads across with her latest drum. But we're now with the leaders, the Cummins family. They've been in front from the start. Mark and Jim working well together. And we go over to the other side of the course. And the tension in this race really starting to build. The Cummins leading by two. There's David McCarthy. The drums, remember, weigh 15 kilograms. But at this stage of the crane drain, they will feel an awful lot heavier. You wouldn't think it to look at the way Jim Cummins is performing. Another one up there for the Tipperary family. David McCarthy does the same for McCarthy's from Clare. The Cummins leading by two from the Maritzes and the McCarthys. And the Ryans are right there with them as well. Now 10 for the McCarthys. But this is Danny Ryan, and he's fumbling with that drum an awful lot. They've made up some ground, but losing time. Need to get moving again.
Go, let's go.
There's Lara Maritz, another drum over there. Christopher, her brother, at the top. Danny's got back into the groove again. Jim's always been in the groove, and David McCarthy moving well. The Cummins lead by one from the McCarthys. The Maritz is dropping to third, and the Ryans, this is impossible to call.
Quick leg.
Lara Maritz to the balance beam. She's had a really good race, but they are slipping behind. The McCarthys, though, have come back into this extremely well after the problems Jason had on the balance beams. Who'll be the first to get the 14th drum up there? And it's the Cummins family. The Cummins family, Jim, has got drum number 14 up there. They've just got one to go. The McCarthys on 13, the Maritzes and the Ryans on 12 apiece. But there is the last drum attached by Mark Cummins, and Jim continues to do his stuff up at the top of the container tower, and they are going to win. They have won. First to 15. Brilliant from Mark and Jim Cummins. Every point counts, though. Who is going to finish in second place? Christopher Maritz gets number 13 up there for his family. The McCarthys, though, have gone to 14 now. Jason and David, can they complete their comeback by finishing in second place? And Jason attaches drum number 15, and off it goes up to the top. The McCarthys are going to finish in second place in the crane drain. There it is, confirmation of a second place finish for them. That was some comeback by them, but every point counts. So it's between the Maritzes and the Ryans for third and fourth, and they're both on their last drum now. Christopher Maritz and Danny Ryan up at the top of the tower, and Danny throws the cable down. Christopher Maritz has got number 15 heading towards the top of the container. Who's it going to be for third place? It's the Maritzes. It's Christopher Maritz. They finished third. And it's fourth place for the Ryans. They finished last for the second time today. That's a surprise.
Hard luck.
Jeez, we nearly pulled that off. We are very close.
Good recovery, lad. Well done.
They've nailed the crane drain, but the Cummins don't know it.
There we go!
Sick! You can't get any higher than two first, like.
Well, do we come first?
Yeah!
Are you sure?
Yeah!
Can we win?
Yeah!
So after the first two events, the Cummins are in first place on 8 points. The McCarthys and the Maritzes are tied on 5 points, which means the crane drain acts as a decider. So the McCarthys are through. Davy Fitzgerald's Maritzes must now join Alan Quinlan's Ryans in today's eliminator.
I'm really gutted about the two events, but I mean, we did give it our all.
Listen, that's what we're here for. It's competition, it's competitive.
We're in the eliminator, and we want to make sure that we try and win that and don't go home.
It was very tough. I nearly gave up in the middle of it, but I think Davy helped me through it.
She looks so small against the boys. She was amazing.
It's tough to take, but I'm so proud of what they've done.
Good afternoon, Cummins and McCarthy family. You have totally avoided the eliminator and you're straight through to the next round of the competition.
The lads did very well now, in fairness, and I'm very proud of them. I'm delighted to be going through into the next round and not doing the eliminator.
By hook or by crook, we're over the line and recovered the way we did. It was exciting for everyone. It's giving the whole team a lift.
We're very lucky there wasn't 16 drums. I wouldn't have been another one.
Jeez, Dad pushed it through, boy. He got there. Going home with two wins is very exciting, I suppose. It's a bit of a boost from the last day.
We should take confidence from today because we won both races, so really happy.
Absolutely brimming with pride. The smile on Jim's face. I waited the entire day to see that smile. This wasn't just about winning. This was about giving them confidence. They're going to go home this evening knowing that they're genuinely here, not just to take part, but to actually compete.
After the break, the Maritzes face the Ryans in the toughest eliminator to date.
Go, go, go!
Where's the fight?
Ready, go!
Welcome back to Ireland's Fittest Family. After a bad start, Stephen Hunt and the McCarthys turned their look around to qualify. Anna Geary's Cummins shocked themselves to get the double win to sail through to the next round.
You can't get any higher than two first, Link.
What did we come for?
Yeah.
Now, after a tough day, the Maritzes and the Ryans have just one chance left to make it through.
This eliminator is the ultimate test. It starts with a nominated family member taking on the monkey bars, then pushing a prowler 75 kg in weight 200 metres through the course to release their families from a container. Together, the families must dash back and face a container pyramid, then onto the ice-cold baths. Awaiting them are two 16-foot Yokohama fenders to conquer. An 8-foot wall will certainly break their stride. Then we go on to the cargo net crawl. And the eliminator ends on the ramp, which has been re-engineered to be steeper and more challenging than ever before.
But there's been a development in Camp Maritz. Earlier in the week in training, Chantelle Maritz took a tumble. Davy's concerned that she may have been injured. A worrying bruise and a trip to the physio confirms the worst.
I just don't think it would be a good idea to strap that up and get out and play. I think there's a risk you might injure yourself further.
But what if I get an injection or a strong painkiller? I don't mind the pain, I'll just go.
Yeah, it's not so much the pain, it's just you might damage the hamstring muscle there.
And it's damaged already, so...
Yeah, no,
It can't be torn again.
Well, it could be torn further. You'd end up with having to get surgery if that was the case, you know?
I'm sorry,
okay.
Kenny.
Listen, doesn't matter. Well done. You've been great. I'm just sorry that had to happen, but we've got to get out now and focus with the lads, and you've got to help them as much as possible.
I feel a bit deflated. I'm annoyed with myself. It's just sorry. It's bad luck, hard luck.
It is what it is now. We've just got to get over this and drive on. It looks like she's a tear in her hamstring, and there is no way that they'll let her compete. What that means is we have to absolutely fight this for her, OK?
Yeah. My mum can't really run, so I think we're just sad now.
I'm tired. Like, my body's just telling me I want to go to bed, but like, I have to push the last push.
I'd say I have to be the strongest then and do whatever it takes.
So Alan picks three family members from the Ryans to face the eliminator. Alana will sit this one out. All hopes are on Dad Danny, Jordan and Keane.
It doesn't change anything around our mindset, but a focus now on a job in hand. You know, this is backs to the wall stuff. We've got to make sure we're really determined and do everything in our power to get this right now.
This is hopefully where we shine. We didn't shine in the other two events, but I believe we'll do this and get through.
We had a disappointing day, but it's not going to stop us, and we're determined to get to the next round, and I think we will.
So with just three members from each family taking part, it's Davy's Maritzes versus Alan's Ryan family in our head-to-head eliminator. And as you know, neither of those boys like to lose.
I'll be running with you, OK? Make a statement here now.
All I want to see is that fight you have. That's what's made me smile all day. So let's give this a go for each other. Is that fair enough?
Yep,
okay,
good.
Let's go on, give it. All right, best of luck.
The families taking their places inside the containers, waiting to be released. Christopher Maritz starting for his family. Danny Ryan beginning for his.
3, 2, 1.
And Joe O'Connor gets the eliminator underway. The monkey bars first. Danny is more than twice Christovan's age. Danny's 43, Christovan is 21, and the younger Christovan is away first.
That's it.
Down to the prowler. It weighs 75 kilograms. And Christovan and Danny have got to push it 200 meters.
That's it, Danny.
And Danny is closing the gap on Christovan Maritz, and he's caught right up with him. and they both pretty much arrive at the same time. They have to climb up an 8 foot high container to release the other two members of their families. But Danny is there. Now there's nothing between the two of them. And out come the Ryans. And out come the Maritzes.
Off you go, off you go.
And now they'll run back down this eliminator course.
I'll bring Dad with you.
To a double container pyramid. And Jordan Ryan has gone out in front. We've seen him do that before. The Maritzes staying together.
Absolutely brilliant.
And Jordan now waiting for Danny and Keane Ryan to join him at the container pyramid.
That helped Jordan.
So Jordan taking that on himself, and Danny helping Keane up there. And here come the Maritzes. Christovan first up. Tess and Lara, the twins, behind him.
Bring him with you. Go.
It's been a tough, demanding day for both of these families.
One
last giant push to survive the eliminator.
Get up.
And two of the Ryans have gone up there. Christovan Maritz. Dragging his sisters up, but the Ryans have an advantage. They have a lead. And Lara is last up for the Maritzes.
Get down under the water. Head under. Head under.
Ice cold water.
Come on, out, hard, hard.
To really bring you back to life.
Put the leg up. Put the leg up. Great position.
So the Ryans leading.
Up, man. Get up. Get up.
To they come up to these Yokohama fenders. But the Maritzes have closed the gap on the Ryans. There's Lara second. Into the water for her family. Can they keep the pressure on the Ryans?
Let's go. Need to get you up there.
Those Yokohama fenders are 16 foot high. And the Ryans really now starting to come into their own. And they're opening up a lead again. It's not much of a lead. But it doesn't need to be. The winners of this eliminator go through. The losers go home. And for coaches Alan and Davey, well, for them, they don't want to be the first coach to lose a family in this year's competition.
Come on, kid.
So that wall was 8 foot high. Danny made that look easy.
Come on. Get up, get up, get up there.
So it's the Ryans still in front. The Maritzes haven't even made it over the second Yokohama fender.
Where's that fight? We need that fight.
This is the Ryans to lose, you would think, at this stage. They're up to the cargo net crawl.
Legs under you. Watch where your foot is. You look back. Look at your feet.
This is not at all easy. No part of this eliminator is easy. Here come the Maritzes.
That's it.
They've work to do.
Get your leg up.
Lara getting over that 8 foot wall on her own. Doesn't need any help. And look at the Ryans, all three of them on that cargo net crawl.
Go on, get up yourself.
And Lara Maritz on her own up there. Christovan helping his sister Tess to get over.
He'll catch him! He'll catch him! Come on!
Well, Davey is convinced that the Maritzes can make up the ground. I wouldn't be so sure. But look at that from Lara Maritz, rolling over that cargo net and making that look so, so easy. It took the Ryans quite a bit of time. They've left the cargo net now. But it's a similar approach for all three of the Maritzes. And now the Ryans take on the ramp, and that's a first fail. So that opens the door for the Maritzes. A second attempt from the Ryans, and they've missed that one again. So Lara's first at the ramp for the Maritzes, and the Ryans have now had three successive failures, and all three Maritzes are over the cargo net crawl.
Ready to go? I need you. I need one up there, lads. I need one up there. Come on. 100% ready to go? 100%! Harder, harder, harder!
This is where the coaches come into their own. Oh, and that's a fourth failure for the Ryans. And what about Christovan Maritz? He can't manage it either. And there is the first man up. Danny's got up for the Ryans. He can be the anchor for Jordan, who takes on the ramp next. And he's got him. And now Christovan Maritz. And he's got up there.
Yes!
He's got up there. And listen to Davy's reaction. Now it's Lara. Can she even things up and make it two apiece? She's been the hero so far today. Christovan couldn't hold on. Now it's Keane Ryan. Have they got him? Yes, they have. Yes, they have. The Ryans survive. They go through. And the Maritzes are on their way home, but they've come so far in this competition, they are going to finish it out. Tess.
Get up!
And Christovan has hold of her.
Get up!
And this really means an awful lot to them to finish this out. They'll be heartbroken that the competition is over. But Lara has performed so well. and she's going to have another go at it, and Chantelle can't watch.
I'm gonna get this, okay? Same thing, okay? Get your breath, get your breath, get your breath, okay?
Battling an awful lot of emotion and disappointment. And Krista Mann has her, and her twin sister Tess does.
Get her!
And that's a lovely moment. So disappointed, but they've finished. They're on the way home, but they will not forget this in a hurry.
I'm absolutely proud. We've won, in my mind, we've won. We've won something in our hearts.
In the end, we did the best. You know, going against three lads, and we still showed them we can do it.
I am proud of myself for doing it. But we tried our best, and we did
Davy
proud, and I think we did our family proud too.
Keep your heads up. That's unreal. What
you
done?
Commiserations. It was so close in the end. You were brilliant to watch, and I know everybody's going to be very sorry to see you go. Davy, you proud of them?
I don't think you can describe the performance they're after giving. They give themselves a shot to win. I don't care what anyone says, you're winners. Like, I would go to war with them any day.
So Davy Fitz is the first coach to lose a team in the competition. And Alan's Rhines have made it through to the next round.
Well done, OK, that was awesome.
I'm really proud of the boys, and I think they've done really well. They couldn't have done any better.
Great battle at the end and a real tough competition.
I'm delighted to be in the final six now. It's a relief.
We went the hard road, but we got here and we're happy to be here.
They showed a lot of character. We made some mistakes, we learned from them and move on, and I'm just delighted to be there the next day.
You're kind of the comeback kids now, because you came last in the first event, you came last in the second event, but then, you know, when you needed to, you won.
We're going to get some kick up the backside from me if we're in the eliminator the next day, so buck up now.
What an amazing eliminator race that was, and the Maritzes are gone. But despite them losing their place in the competition, it seems they have won a place in Davy Fitz's heart forever. Next week, our coaches field their second families right here in Dublin Port. We'll see you then.
You have to stay there. You have to stay there.
Come on, lads, come on.
Hold on, hold on.
You have to believe in your mind right now that you can do this.
Come on, I need more, Audi.
Those Yokohama fenders are 16 foot high. And the Ryans really now starting to come into their own, and they're opening up a lead again. It's not much of a lead, but it doesn't need to be. The winners of this eliminator go through, the losers go home, and for coaches Alan and Davy, well, for them, they don't want to be the first coach to lose a family in this year's competition.
Come on, kid.
So that wall was 8 foot high. Danny made that look easy.
Come on. Get up, get up, get up there.
So it's the Ryans still in front. The Maritzes haven't even made it over the second Yokohama fender.
Where's that fight? We need that fight.
This is the Ryans to lose, you would think, at this stage. They're up to the cargo net crawl.
Legs under you. Watch where your foot is. You look back. Look at your feet.
This is not at all easy. No part of this eliminator is easy. Here come the Maritzes.
That's it.
They've work to do.
Get your leg up.
Lara getting over that 8 foot wall on her own, doesn't need any help. And look at the Ryans, all three of them on that cargo net crawl.
Go on, get up yourself.
And Lara Maritz on her own up there. Christovan helping his sister Tess to get over.
Come on, come on. You'll catch him. Come on.
Davy is convinced that the Maritzes can make up the ground. I wouldn't be so sure. But look at that from Lara Maritz, rolling over that cargo net and making that look so, so easy. It took the Ryans quite a bit of time. They've left the cargo net now, but it's a similar approach for all three of the Maritzes. And now the Ryans take on the ramp, and that's a first fail. So that opens the door for the Maritzes, a second attempt from the Ryans, and they've missed that one again. So Lara's first at the ramp for the Maritzes, and the Ryans have now had three successive failures, and all three Maritzes are over the cargo net crawl.
Ready to go?
I need one up there, lads. I need one up there. Come on.
100% ready to go? 100%.
Harder.
This is where the coaches come into their own. Oh, and that's a fourth failure for the Ryans. And what about Cristobal Maritz? He can't manage it either. And there is the first man up. Danny's got up for the Ryans. He can be the anchor for Jordan, who takes on the ramp next. And he's got him. And now Cristobal Maritz. And he's got up there.
Yes!
He's got up there. And listen to Davy's reaction. Now it's Lara. Can she even things up and make it two apiece? She's been the hero so far today. Cristobal couldn't hold on. Now it's Keane Ryan. Have they got him? Yes, they have. Yes, they have. The Ryans survive. They go through. And the Maritzes are on their way home. But they've come so far in this competition. They are going to finish it out. Tess.
Get up!
And Cristobal has hold of her.
Get up!
And this really means an awful lot to them to finish this out. They'll be heartbroken that the competition is over. But Lara has performed so well. And she's going to have another go at it. And Chantelle can't watch.
Same thing. Okay, get your breath. Get your breath. Get your breath. Okay.
Battling an awful lot of emotion and disappointment.
You get her!
And Cristobal has her, and her twin sister Tess does.
Get her!
And that's a lovely moment. So disappointed, but they've finished. They're on the way home, but they will not forget this in a hurry.
I'm absolutely proud. We've won, in my mind, we've won. We've won something in our hearts.
In the end, we did the best. You know, going against three lads, and we still showed them we can do it.
I am proud of myself for doing it. We're sad, but we tried our best, and we did Davy proud, and I think we did our family proud too.
Keep your heads up. That's unreal. What you done?
Commiserations. It was so close in the end. You were brilliant to watch, and I know everybody's going to be very sorry to see you go. Dave, are you proud of them?
I don't think you can describe the performance they're after giving. They give themselves a shot to win. I don't care what anyone says, you're winners. Like, I would go to war with them any day.
So Davy Fitz is the first coach to lose a team in the competition. And Alan's Ryans have made it through to the next round.
Welcome to Ireland's Fittest Family, Mud, Sweat and Tears. Tonight, we'll be looking back at the biggest, toughest and hardest moments in Fittest Family history. We'll be hearing from the families and coaches who over the last 4 years have pushed themselves to their limits and beyond, and all with just one aim, to win the title of Ireland's Fittest Family.
Come on! Take the camera out of the way!
But there's one thing that has claimed and broken spirits of many a fit family.
The bog jog.
The bog.
The bog jog.
The bog.
Probably the hardest obstacle of all is the bog jog.
It's a cold, lonely, horrible place. I don't ever want to go into the bog again.
Come on, Ireland!
Come on, Jordan!
Let's just say I wouldn't like to be doing it every day. But it's brilliant.
The bog. It's claimed shoes, dignity and self-respect, but you can't argue that it is the ultimate test of fitness. Enjoy, but this ain't gonna be pretty.
And from then on, the bog has been pushing our families to limits they never knew they had.
Come on, Kevin.
Start looking ahead.
Totally stuck in the mud. Has he got anything left to give?
It's so hard to keep a smile from my face. Jokers to the right, here I am, stuck in the middle with you. Here I am, stuck in the middle with you.
Good stuff, good lad. There they
are. Oh dear.
In true Fittest Family style, hanging tough has proven it's often those you least expect that surprise you.
We've seen, you know, young girls of 14, 15 years of age outdo their parents and their older siblings quite easily.
Two standout hanging tough champions were this year's 15-year-old twins, Tess and Lara Maritz from Dublin.
Everyone said, these girls, they won't last that long.
I say to the kids, they just have to go to a quiet place.
And hang tough they did.
We worked on, once we start, Let's get our mind someplace else. Let's not concentrate. If someone drops, forget about it. Just keep focused ahead.
Close your eyes and just focus.
Christovan as well. And Christovan, surprisingly, has gone in.
I was surprised when Christovan went before the girls. That was really funny.
So it's all down to the twins.
Now you have to stay, Lara.
Test gone in. And Lara...
How did you do it, Lara? What did you do?
I was just listening to Davey and I closed my eyes and just kept listening to Davey.
15-year-old Lara is fighting with all she's worth to stay up there.
She just wasn't coming down. That was it.
Well, she's gone into the water 2:23, but that is absolutely brilliant.
I was extremely proud of her. Like, I didn't expect it, because when we were practicing this beforehand, she was barely holding on for a few seconds.
Right.
My God. They were brilliant. Absolutely brilliant.
For our families and coaches, something that can quite literally get in the way of winning a race are the Fittest family obstacles. Designed to cause maximum disruption, these obstacles can stop a family dead in their tracks.
The families face a container pyramid.
A lot of climbs, you're going through that cold water.
They'll encounter ice baths, electric shocks.
Just year after year, it keeps getting tougher.
20-foot monkey bar swing. 16 feet of narrow balance beams.
There's so many surprises in our Little Fittest family.
A 30-foot barbed wire crawl. There's no let up all the way around this course. The only way out is over the towering 10-foot wall.
In Series 4, the ramp lay at the end of the grueling eliminator for the Maritz family. They had been behind the Hollands in orange throughout the entire race.
And the panic will be with the Maritzes. They're trying to make up ground.
They needed to pull out all the stops to get up that ramp.
And that was very close from Tess Maritz. Very
well
close,
done.
Just
go
isn't
on.
Good enough. Christovan has got up there.
Well, Christovan was up and Lara was up and I thought, OK, it's fine. I just need to catch my breath. And then Tess, she froze a bit. She really struggled to get up there.
No, see, I thought you were going to go, so I was waiting for you.
You were waiting for me?
I was like, you can go.
We're making turns to go on a ramp.
The pressure is building. The panic builds as well. And the Maritzes have got three, have they? Have they? It's down to the parents, Steve Holland and Chantelle Maritz. The tension of this is absolutely incredible. It's as tight as it gets. They're both being clung onto.
When I got up eventually and I was so tired, I just lay down and then I was like, did we make it? Yes.
Seeing them fight every inch was fantastic.
That was actually incredible, wasn't it?
Unbelievable.
We realised we've won and I'm really tired. I just started crying. I just could not believe it. I don't know if it was relief or if it was joy or if it was pain because my whole body was aching. I could barely breathe. But I just cried. I was so emotional. It's so embarrassing. I'm crying on national TV.
Yeah, that's what she said to us.
Did I say that? Yeah. Can't believe I'm crying, but I'm still crying.
But you could see the emotion of how happy they were, that the effort they gave and what they'd done. And that was a high moment for me.
Oh, no, we won. We're going to do it all again.
Well, that's it. Our journey through Fittest Families, mud, sweat and tears comes to an end. For me, the coaches and our families, it's been an epic 4 years. And who knows, next time it might be your super fit family on top of the ramp. We'll see you then.